with this English rabble since they're threatening evil Fizz Osburn.
Where shall we strike?
Let's attack them right from here. Can I join in? Ooh, my dude might be able to join in on that fight. Cool. Let's just move them here then. Oh, we can't attack now. Gosh darn it. Uh-oh. I messed something up. Okay, I'll be right back. Alright, so I messed that up. So we're not going to have this guy join in, because that will remove all my movement points. And I need them to send Only the Far back to Colneceaster, or they'll riot. So there we go, what we got. We have peasants and peasants. Are you serious? Oh my goodness, it's going to be a slaughter. Okay, I'm going to just show you them getting run down, and then the result screen. I'll be right back. I'm not even going to do anything fancy. Not at all. They're peasants, for crying out loud. So I'm just going to run them down with my cavalry, as you can see. And they're going to go flying, hopefully. Hopefully. But I'm amazed. I think the English are really shattered now that we killed most of their leaders. And oh, here we go. Oh, they're broken. Go figure. All right. Now, let's just line ourselves up for another charge, shall we? There we go. And we took their, historical capital and all sorts of crazy stuff. Okay, another charge. Charge there. Charge there. Charge there. Oh my goodness, I actually lost a knight to a peasant. Ooh, I lost two of them. That's a shame. There we go. I'm going to run these dogs down, and I'll get back to you at the result screen. There we go, clear victory, 367 kills, didn't leave a single one alive. Unfortunately, I lost three knights. I guess they got too, impatient, sloppy. Alright, so let's send these guys back to Colneceaster. And I don't think we need these serfs. Oh. Use one surf. Yeehaw. I think what I'm going to do next in Colneceaster now is actually recruit a muster field, and that way I can have spearmen and not these silly serfs. So since these guys aren't really going to help me, I'm going to build a spy until next turn. That'll be cool. Then I can spy on the Welsh or something. Alright, and let's take this final English holding in this region. What's this region called? I think it's a part of Ludenvik. Let's find out. Let's educate myself. Earldom of Essex. Oh, I get it. East. Essex. Okay. So the last little province of Essex. Alright, so let's just assault them. We have ourselves peasants, soaksmen, and lightfurred. I will see you at the battle. Alright, so this is going to be pretty simple. Gonna bash down them gates. And I'm going to archer the poop out of these guys. Actually, wait. Archer the poop out of these guys. Wow. I'm classy. Have them stop. And let's just line up my archers to fire upon the English from behind their walls. That'll do. Alright, I'll get back to you. There we go. Now the arrows are flying, and the soaksmen are dying, and they came out of their gates for some reason. You fools, run, run. You know, it would be really nice, and they do have this later in the Total War games, but just invoking the enemy to surrender their town, which would make sense. I mean, it doesn't really matter how, well, no, I guess that's not true. It doesn't matter what odds, there are always men who will defend their homes, regardless of the odds against them. Maybe this kind of just represents that. Anyways, with such happy thoughts, I'll get back to you once all these poor little digital dudes are dead. Oh, I made a small mistake. I lost a few archers here because I wasn't paying attention to that guard tower. Oh well. The soaksmen are almost dead, as you can see. There we go, that was the last of the soaksmen. So now, we're going to just wait for the rest of these gates to bash on down. And we'll only have to worry about a little bit of peasants and these ferdmen that are hanging about down by the town square. So I'll get set up and get back to you again. Alright, I decided to do something a little bit fancier this time. I'm setting up my men here. I'm putting them in like a single, I guess you could say, wall. I put them on defensive mode, and I have my archers right here. So I'm going to fire upon these men, force them to come around this way, and then once they're done, once they're completely out of town square, I'm going to bring in my cavalry, bring them behind here, have them charge them from behind, break them, and then finish the battle nice and quick. So let's see how well that strategy works out. We're going to put these guys back on fire at will. They'll shoot at these fellows here, they'll come on out. I'll then take them off of fire at will so I don't hit my own men in the back, which would be bad. Ah yes, here they come. And the longer it takes, the more of them I get to kill with my arrows, which is always nice. Okay, so we're going to take these guys off of fire at will now. And we're going to start to set up my cavalry. I guess I didn't need to bring all four units. In fact, oh, there we go. That'll work. Run. Let's just keep firing at these guys right now. Good, I'm not running my cavalry just yet. They're approaching slowly. I gotta be careful of their javelins, that's for sure. There we go. There we go. Perfect. Alright, now we'll take these... Oh, see, because I already hit my own men at once. There, but there we go. Alright, now it's time to charge them from behind, so... let's just do two units right now, while the other two set up. We'll just have them run, and run, and you guys run. No, 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 no. There we go. Don't hide in your town square. There we go. They've broken. And I've won, so let's just end that battle. Clear victory with only 22 losses, mostly from arrow fire. Alright, I'll get back to you at the campaign map. And I think for this settlement, we're going to probably lay it to waste. We have a couple major centers now, Ludenvik, Oxenford, and Wittenkaster, that they're on low taxes with a population of between 2,000 and 3,000, and I'm just recruiting a little bit at a time, so I think we'll have enough manpower. And we're going to teach these fellows a lesson to be the last resistance in Wessex, so we're going to lay it to waste. It'll be ever so easy to control this now. And local lordship for now, because I do want to convert all these settlements to Norman rule, but there's still some unrest and unhappiness. So we're going to just put these guys on local lordship for now, wait about 5 turns, and then we'll probably convert this entire area. Alright, so instead of me humming and hawing and deciding what to build, I've actually decided already, and I'm just going to show you what I'm going to build here. So in Kane, I'm building a stockade, Chernberg, a slipway, in Profensie, a Norman Satter Hall, Lundvik, Christian Shrine, Kentwabara, a cider house, Wittenkaster, a merchant priory in Wisgarsborough. My goodness. Oxenford gets Norman Butts. Helmham gets Norman Satter Hall. Gipswich gets a wooden palisade. Glowcaster gets a Norman mustard field. And Colneceaster gets local lordship. So this is interesting. My agent here in that was just came out of Glowcaster is a proponent of Marcher Law, which could help my chances with converting the populace a little bit, at least. Unfortunately, Henri de Ferrar, his influence has gone down a little bit, but once he stays here for another turn, it should go up by a couple more points, hopefully, at least. Ooh, we're now the most widespread people. We own the most land. Awesome. And at the top of the turn, we also have a candidate for adoption from Richard Fitzgilbert. He's a feudal law Christian, and he's sharp. Good enough for me. Now, where is he, is the question. Ah, he's in Northampton. Well, let's not give him Northampton. Let's give him someplace a little bit better, shall we? Let's see here. Where are some of... We have so many places. Boulogne? Does Boulogne not have a leader? No, it doesn't. Well, congratulations, buddy. You are now going to be the governor of Valone. So let's send you over. Come on. This way. We'll say to Profensi. And there they will build you a boat. Can we build something better? There we go. A longboat. Build a longboat there. Send it on over to pick you up. And then send you off to Boulogne. Congratulations. There we go. And we have one full stack right here led by Yvonne Fitz Osburn. And we're going to take Colneceaster first. Then move up to here. To Seador. And continue on that away. Ooh, what's all this? Oh, it's low mountains. Alright, over here in Colneceaster, we're going to take the army out.
An order, Seigneur.
Oh my goodness, they're quite stable. Who'd have thought? Put them on a low policy. We want to recruit a Norman muster field. And by then, we should have some sort of garrison there, though. Not my mercenaries. Any spearmen? There's some spearmen. Congratulations. There's your new home. There we go. We can even up the taxes now. Yeehaw. Alright, so the plan is now is we're going to have these guys meet up. I'm going to head back to Ludenvik with these men. And I'm going to retrain this army. I'm going to reform it. And it's going to go up north. And, meet up with Richard Fitzgilbert, and we're going to start pushing up this eastern coast up north while we continue our fight down here. The really nice thing about that is that this section can be defended by our good old-fashioned Henri de Ferrat. He's a good commander with a decent force that can do wonders for defense.